not a teddy bear per se, but the infamous Shawbot Bud is joining me on this week's show here from Riverside Park at the Teddy Bear Picnic. Hundreds of people behind me here with their stuffed animals taking part in some of the fun festivities here. A number of organizations locally take part in hosting this event. So coming up in the show, we're going to chat with a couple of those, plus a parent or two about their experience, why they bring their kid out here to the Teddy Bear Picnic. Lots of fun to be had, so stick around for that. First though, the Kamloops Senior Symposium wrapped up recently, and we take a look at how successful this year's event was. We're here at the Teddy Bear Picnic in Riverside Park. Beautiful weather, lots of people around here. Perfect day. Maureen is joining us now. Thanks for coming on the show.
Thanks for having us. We're super excited to have you here.
Yeah, happy to be here. Lots of fun. What is today all about for these people here?
It's about the four-letter word play, P-L-A-Y. That's really what it's about. This is the event where we just encourage families from every walks of life in Kamloops with young children and preschools and daycares to come down and to play together and have fun and just really celebrate the joy and the uniqueness of every child that is here today.
We talk a lot about literacy with you, reading, active listening with your kids. How is play important? It's lots of fun, obviously, that's right. In the word, but how does it benefit these kids as well developmentally?
Play is the foundation. It's the foundation for learning. When we are having fun and we're interested in what we're learning about, we're going to retain more information. It's all about, it builds our memory, it connects our right and left brain, our movement, it gets us ready to read and to write. It helps us have self-regulation, like know how far is too far, how rough is too rough. It teaches us empathy by doing like creative play. We have a teddy bear hospital, so children are helping nurse their sick teddy bears back to health, and they're helping each other. So really, it's just the foundation, and everything builds from there.
It's the best kind of learning because you don't even know you're learning.
Exactly. And absolutely. Absolutely.
So maybe set a scene for us. There's lots going on. We've got so much behind us. What are kids able to do here today?
We really try and encompass all of the areas of early childhood and development. So for example, right behind me, we have got Project X, a lot of our theater groups. So we have Project X, Chimera, and Rivertown Players. And they're pretending right now to be jesters and actors. And they're engaging the children in that imagination too and having them sort of create the story. Right behind me, we have the simplest tool available, a parachute. You can use a blanket at home, you can use a scarf, and children run in, and they watch the colors, and they run out. And what that is doing is it's teamwork. It's also big movements. We're moving our arms up and down. We're running in and out. And again, we're pretending for it to be whatever we want it to be. And then we have a storybook corner. So if you're, you know, kind of getting tired and you need to sort of lay down and sort of chill a little bit, we have our storybook corner with the Bright Red Book Bus, and the circus train that was at ABC Day is also down here for children to pretend to be whatever they want to be in there, big old engineers. We have art always available because a lot of our creativity comes from that tactile play of actually holding a crayon and creating something their own. And then we have the bouncy fire station, which is always really, enough said there. Children love to jump.
If it bounces, they will come.
If it bounces, they will come. That's so true. Wow. And then we have some music stations, and we have some movement like with River City Gymnastics and Pacific Sports. And Fit by Design is doing a free family Zumba class right now, and then they're all going to come down and do that together here. And then we have a garden station, because why not, with Kamloops' very own Marigold Planting Station, so everybody gets a little something to take home with them.
You're often behind the scenes working on many events throughout the town, often fundraisers and stuff, but what's it like to just kind of let everything go and have fun yourself too? I'm sure it's been a lot of planning, but this is a fun day for you too.
It's, you know what, it's a fun day for all of us wearing these yellow t-shirts. The committee, most of us actually work on a lot of the events that the Kamloops Story Language and Literacy puts on, and this is our day to sort of unwind as well. Like, all of our work really is sort of done by 10 o'clock by the time it happens, and we get to go meet and greet the families that maybe we've worked with at the various other areas that we work in, whether it's the library, the CCRR, Parent Child Mother Goose, which I facilitate a lot. So we really get to come and have fun as well. And as soon as Zumba starts, for sure we're all going to be on this grass in the middle here having some fun too.
Leah Miller is up next with a behind the scenes look at this year's Miss Kamloops program. She stepped in and took part in the auto workshop. Hundreds of parents and kids out here today at Riverside Park taking part in the annual Teddy Bear Picnic. Lots of stuffed animals to be found. And we're joined now by a parent, Tanya. Thanks for coming on the show.
Oh, you're so welcome.
So you've attended this before. It's not your first time. What drew you out this time? What do you like about this event?
I think it's amazing. Now that I have a daughter who's in grade one, I understand the need to have sort of a culmination to the end of the year. My children and I have come to Mother Goose pretty much since they were babies, since we first moved here 5.5 years ago. That time to connect with my children is so important, and what Maureen Dahl offers and the Kelly program offers here at the Mother Goose program at the end of the year is a real beautiful celebration of the work and the play that is so important that goes along with this program and the Kelly program all year. Mother Goose is such a huge, important part of our lives. And this is just a really fun place for, not as much now, but especially when the kids were really little, to connect with other parents and sort of make those connections for the rest of the summer, because sometimes you may not be seeing anybody over the summer. There's a long gap.
We talk a lot with Maureen about that connection between learning and playing as well. There's got to be a balance, and you can do both at the same time as well. So how do you incorporate that at home? How do you take that into the home with your kids to make sure that they're having time to play and learn? And
We read a ton at home, but it's mostly in the car. We sing a lot of songs for distraction, rhymes. My six-year-old now is super into Down by the Bay Where the Watermelons Grow. She's so proud of herself when she makes a rhyme, and the little sister, of course, wants to go along with that. It's just everything. I became a facilitator because of the value of this program, because I want to share it with other families.
Thank you so much for coming on the show, Tanya.
My pleasure, Sam.
Happy to have you. We're going to throw some information on the bottom of the screen about Parent Child Mother Goose if you'd like to check it out for yourself. I know it's kind of hot in demand, so you might have to be on the wait list or something for next year.
Check out the Parent Child Mother Goose Facebook page and follow that page to find out exactly when the registration opens. If you're kind of not making that calendar note in your book, you're not going to get
absolutely.
It.
Yeah. We'll throw that on the bottom of the screen. Stick around. There's more Go coming up here from the Teddy Bear Picnic, only on Shaw TV. If you're just joining us on Shaw TV, this week we're down here at the Teddy Bear Picnic, taking in all the fun, the festivities. Marianne joining us now, the District Early Years Coordinator for the school district. Thanks for coming on the show.
Well, thank you so much for having me.
Happy to have you. Now, talk a little bit about kind of the link between the summer and the school year. Oftentimes, maybe parents become a little more lax with keeping kids up with their reading or something, but how can kids maintain what they've learned and developed over the year?
For sure, we don't want that break. No. Your parents are their first teachers, not just teachers in the school district. Yeah. So we want to encourage that reading over the summer. We have our Bright Red Book Bus, which is just an awesome service that the school district has partnered with Boys and Girls Club and other agencies in order to continue that reading program. There's many different stops all over Kamloops during that summer, including special schools that were targeted that host our summer reading actual intervention programs that are happening this summer too.
We've got some people behind us as well. This is something that you guys provide as well. Strong Start,
yeah.
Very popular. What is that program all about?
So Strong Start is our 0 to 4 program that incorporates children and parents into the school itself in order to learn how to play productively play and acquire those reading and literacy skills and help their children out before the school year starts. Get them ready for kindergarten and get them excited about coming to school.
Cool. Oftentimes people think that to teach kids how to read, you have to sit down and read a book, but it can often be a little more simple than that and a lot more fun.
It can. It's all about play, and it's play for purpose. It's providing provocations. It's actually based on our new curriculum, which is me. I'm getting a plug-in for the new curriculum. It's amazing how much parents can learn from that. And it's just about engaging kids in play activities that encourage those skills, and they don't even realize that they're acquiring those skills because they're having so much fun doing it, as well as parents doing it as well.
We were talking with Maureen earlier, and we said the best kind of learning is learning that you don't even know you're doing.
That's right. Yeah. Absolutely. Cool. That's best learning.
Thanks for coming on the show, Marianne.
Well, thanks so much for having me.
No problem. Up next, Addiction Matters Kamloops is hosting an event on June 23rd, and we got a sneak peek. You're watching Go only on Shaw TV. Sabrina joining us now.
Hello.
fitness expert, we can
say. Yeah, that's right. Fit by Design. How are you?
Good. How are you?
Good. Great.
So you taught a class today. You kind of did some fun dancing and exercising with the kids.
Yeah.
We're talking about play and learning today. How important is movement, physicality with kids?
It's so important. The thing with kids being inside most of the day and not getting to be out as much as they used to be is that when they get home, they need that interaction, especially with their parents too, right? So it's super important for them to come out and have some fun. So at Fit by Design, what we do is we actually get the kids to play. And so the fitness becomes playing and it becomes just natural to them. So it's not like they're going out to do something that's tough, they're going to do something that's fun and they're doing it with their parents. Not every kid loves sports, and that's what I'm coming to learn. And so if we could get them to incorporate healthy living at a young age, then it just seems natural.
Yeah. And really quickly, for parents at home who are trying to do this, maybe keep up with the kids, what are some three top tips to get your kid moving with you?
Oh, man. Well, first of all, just ask them, right? So just say, you know what, I want to get outside with you and play. Maybe not make it a specific sport. So just get outside with them. And you actually do the activity with them. So it's not, let's go to the park and I'm going to sit down and I'm going to watch you play. Get in there and like go on the swings and you know, do the monkey bars. And then you know what's really fun is we love to make obstacle courses at home. So we just take stuff that's at home and we put like markers and we do running and we do shuttle runs and leapfrog. We just did a class with all these kids and they just love to be with their parents. So just, you know, involve them.
Perfect. Yeah. Thanks for coming on the show, Sabrina.
Thank you.
We're going to throw your information on the bottom of the screen as well if people want more details. Stick around. There's more Go coming up only on Shaw TV. I hope you've enjoyed watching our episode here from the Teddy Bear Picnic in Riverside Park. So much fun talking to some of the organizers and a parent about why they come out here, why they bring their kids out here, and of course the importance of play. If you'd like more information about the Kamloops Parent Child Mother Goose program, we've also got some information about the school district and some other organizations that helped make this day possible here. We'll throw them on the bottom of the screen and you can check them out for yourself. Thanks again to my guests for chatting with me this week. We're online as well at Shaw TV Kamloops on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. We'd love to interact with you there. Again, I'm your host, Sam Nomes, and thanks so much for watching. We'll see you next time.